in your neighborhood, and we're at the Monroe County History Museum. Norma Reyes joining us right now, but there's one person who's largely responsible for this museum. Who is it?
Ed Kuecker. Ed Kuecker is our benefactor, and it's the reason that we have this museum. For 35 years, Ed had a museum in Red Barn behind his home. In 1999, he decided he was going to donate the collection to the Water Museum Society. The Museum Society had to be formed in order to accept it.
And so you started it up.
And we started it up. Oh yeah, that was really that easy.
Okay.
Receiving a collection of 4,000 pieces ranging in size from military coin to a stagecoach.
Yeah, take us on a tour here, Norma, if we go past the stagecoach and...
But then we didn't have any land, no money, no building, and we had to do all of that. So the collection wound up in the barn for several years. And in 2007, we had our groundbreaking on the ground that was donated from the Monroe County Historical Society. And in 2008, we opened. So we've only been open 10 years.
Yeah, tell us about the storefront here.
The storefront Ed Kuecker found and wanted to have the front part of it from the Red Bud Treber store. So he made arrangements with his nephew to go down and get it, which he did the day they demolished it in 1986.
Margie, I've already said this show needs more cowbell. I found it.
Yes.
Look at that.
More cowbell. That's exactly what we need.
Got it.
Timmy, this looks like something you'd work on.
What? The pencil?
Bunch of pencils. Yeah. Norma, what's this all about?
Well, Ed Kuecker never let the grass grow under his feet, and he always did a lot of things. And one of the things that he did was build pencil houses. He built them according to scale. And this is what he thought the Fort Pickett would have looked like in Columbia. They were doing research, archaeological digging and stuff, trying to figure it out. They still haven't found exactly where it was.
Sue Waters joining us now with one of your signature pieces in the museum, the stagecoach.
This is a replica of a stagecoach. Ed Kuecker bought this when he was searching for a team of horses in Iowa. And the man that owned the stagecoach and the horses said, I'll only sell it to you if you take the stagecoach. Well, we've already seen that Ed loved to collect Western items. Mm-hmm. So that was something he really already wanted.
And back here we have a lot of stuff dealing with war.
Yes, this on the right is a World War I wagon, something you don't see very often because we don't think of horse-drawn wagons in World War I. So this is a good display of many things that you would see in World War I.
Now we've entered your presentation space where you can have programs.
Yes.
Very nice. And then a very rare car. Tell me about this.
This car is a 1917 Chevrolet. It's a V8. It was the first model made of this particular car. There are only three were made in 1917, and we have one. The Smithsonian in Washington, D.C. has one, and we feel that the third one was used for parts.
So much to see here at the museum, more than we have time to
show
you.
We're just scratching the surface.
You've got to come check it out. You got to come visit for yourself.
Yeah, History Museum of Monroe County. Ladies, thank you so much for the tour.
Thank
we appreciate
you.
It.
You bet.
Stick around. Yes, thank you. Much more ahead for you. Fox 2 News in the Morning, live from Waterloo.